here. I, Chitrakshi Dubey, and I, Masira Sheikh, on behalf of Srimati Vinatadevi Tope Social Service League, welcome you to the much awaited first Dr. Trimbakrishna Tope Memorial Lecture and the 9th edition of Shikhar 2016 Education from Charity Space. Social Service League is one of the oldest committees of the college, established by their principal Dr. Trimbakrishna Tope, and we are proud to celebrate the semi-centennial anniversary of the League. The League has grown leaps and bounds over the past glorious 50 years. The manner in which a single ray of light, a single precious hint, enlightens the soul of him who receives it. We enlighten the lamp on this auspicious occasion with eliminating the darkness of iniquity and spreading lights of joy and happiness. I invite all our dignitaries for a ceremonious lighting of the lamp.
Welcome to one and all present here, and glad to be a part of the semi-centennial anniversary of Srimati Vinatadevi Tope Social Service League. The oldest committee of the college has set a benchmark in its work with events like Udaan, an inter-NGO competition and Shikhar exhibition. Social Service League has always come out with flying colors. Now with the inaugural first Dr. Trimbakrishna Tope Memorial Lecture 2016, the League has proved that there is nothing which can stop them from reaching greater heights. We are indeed privileged to have amongst us some of the greatest names of the present time. I express my deep gratitude towards Honorable Mr. Justice B.M. Srikrishna, Sri Dharmadhikari, Honorable Mr. Julio Ribeiro, and Mrs. Manjula Saboo. My friend, when we talk about the former principal, Dr. Trimbakrishna Tope, words will never be enough to express what a great personality he was and what he means for the college. He has been a continuous inspiration for all of us, and it gives me immense pleasure to be a part of this social legal lecture series. I would also like to congratulate Social Service League for organizing yet another edition of Shikhar Exhibition Cup Charity Sale. The theme for the year, Eliminating Education Inequity, gives us a chance to ponder about the present education system in the country. Education, being cardinal component of human dignity, is basic structure of education. The subject is very sensitive. Today, we see that even admission in lower KG almost costs thousands and lakhs of rupees. Admission to the medical engineering colleges costs crores of rupees. which is beyond the reach of any honest officer, judicial officer, minister. Justice Krishna has observed in his book, Judges Patpauri, that this century we hear testimony to Bharat divided. The few reach with their children, enjoying education and later professional corruption, and demand of large dowry to make good the early heavy investment. And on the other hand, the millions of harrods sense any education, employment, slowly losing faith in Swaraj. While we strive to give our best to provide the best education possible, I deeply regret the discrimination present in the society. With this aim, we aspire to fight for a fair method of education where natural rights are not harmed, morality stands strong, and equity explicitly expresses itself. Once again, I welcome all of you and congratulate the league for their commendable work. Thank you very much.
Admirable educational inequity. We are indeed honored and privileged to have such dignitaries who have not only contributed towards the cause of education over their illustrious career, but they all have been alumni of this prestigious institution.
I now request Principal Sir to felicitate our chief guest and keynote speaker, Honorable Mr. Justice B. H. Srikrishna. Honorable Mr. Justice S.C. Dharmadhikari.
I request so to felicitate our guest of honor and keynote speaker, Sri Junior Ribeiro. I now request sir to felicitate our guest of honor and keynote speaker, Ms. Manjula Saboo.
Distinguished jurist, two-time chancellor of University of Mumbai, sheriff of Mumbai, and the longest serving principal of Government Law College, Mumbai. A descendant of the revolutionary Tatya Tope and an associate of Dr. V.R. Ambedkar, Dr. Tope was the first law teacher in India to have the honor of being a member of Law Commission of India and Maharashtra State Law Commission, an authority on constitutional and Hindu law and a firm believer in social service. It is indeed fitting to have our golden anniversary dedicated to his fond memory. Those who knew Dr. Tope personally considered him to be a stern disciplinarian and a kind-hearted man. One such person is our distinguished guest of honor, Honorable Mr. Justice S.C. Dharmadhikari.
Born in the family of lawyers, Honorable Mr. Justice Satyaranjan C. Dharmadhikari is a legal stalwart. He has handled all types of civil and constitutional cases, including service matters and election petitions. Sitting judge in the Bombay High Court, he has also been actively associated with the legal aid movement and our very own social service league. With immense pleasure, we invite Honorable Mr. Justice S.C. Dharmadhikari to give us a glimpse of the eventful life of this stern disciplinarian and kind-hearted man.
Honorable Mr. Justice B. N. Srikrishna, Mr. Ribeiro, the other dignitaries on the dais, family members of Dr. Tope and student friends. I start with an apology because the court assembles at 11 o'clock and I have taken the leave of His Lordship Justice Srikrishna to leave. The dignitaries on the dais remind me of the personality of my father-in-law, Dr. Tope. I stand here because I was told that I am one of the family members and I need to share some memories of the man as a family member, as a teacher, and as a strict disciplinarian. Friends, I was the last to enter the family of Dr. Tope. Married to his youngest daughter, I came in touch with him really as a father-in-law from 1991. It was a very brief association from 1991 till his death in 1994. But prior to that, in this very premises, I have attended his lectures as a student of the LLM course. I have also seen him in action, but not as a principal of this college, because when I entered this college, he had already retired. He had debited office and was bestowed with a further and a greater honor of a vice chancellor of this Mumbai University. Friends, he was essentially a family man. He came from very humble beginnings, never forgot his hometown, Yavla, in district Nasik. He always cared for those have-nots, those downtrodden, who were deprived of basic amenities and education. He knew that from that hometown he grew up and he came to Mumbai and made a career and name for himself. But town, that small it is, he never forgot it. In the gathering there are several ladies and they will remember Yavla for a paithani sari. But Yavla is also known for producing people like Dr. Tope. Dr. Tope established and helped a lot of people there establish premier educational institutions so that the education reaches those sections of the society who are deprived of it for decades together. Friends, he was always a teacher and teacher at heart, not a teacher of today. To recite, to narrate, to write something on the blackboard is not teaching. He believed that there are several alternate words from where you search the meaning of teaching and to educate. Possibly he had in mind all such eyes to instill, to inculcate, to impart, to instruct, to imbibe, to impress is what is to educate. Dr. Tope understood this from very early beginning of his career as a teacher. He was aware that a teacher is not teaching a class or a student, but he is making them aware of what the society is, the reality of the world is. As a law teacher, friends, you need not just know the provisions of law, but you must know the spirit and the intent of the legislature. Certain laws are made for public good, but never reach the people. Dr. Tope was aware that there are not many people in this world who have no access to justice. There is a place which is less than 100 kilometers away from Mumbai in Thane district, where you still see how the Adivasis, how those belonging to the scheduled tribes have to lead their life. Once I came to this college and I was associated with this league, that I came to know that it was established
with this view in mind by Dr. Tope. The activities of this league were aimed at improving the lot of these people, these sections of the society. And friends, this was not just a lip service. This was an active involvement. All students would go and work amongst them. Even now, I am informed and I have been very happy because this is the second occasion that I am involved with this Shikhar, that the students of this institution reach out to them, give them legal aid, give them opportunity to do something in life, to make it meaningful and purposeful, to earn livelihood, and by giving a market to their products. And every year, possibly during this time of the year, we have this exhibition, and that is one of the activities. Friends, Dr. Tope was not just a disciplinarian. He was a very soft and gentle person, essentially a family man. He loved to help and assist people in growing and really growing and making a personality of one's own. The building of one's personality, the confidence that he would give to all his family members, his students, is remembered even now. Friends, as a disciplinarian, I will only tell you two things. Once Dr. Tope was in the saddle, people knew that the campus would never be polluted. It would never become an arena of power politics and very petty power politics back to its student community. He would never allow the place to be converted into anything except a place of learning where there is regard, respect and love for academic excellence and hard work. The atmosphere was not allowed to be polluted by him, even at the cost of his health. A man who knew his limitations. He always knew that there are younger people and more intelligent people of scholarship, people of erudition and learning in the legal profession and public life. They were younger to him, yet he admired them. During conversations that I had with him, he always had very, very kind words to say and respectful words for the members of the judiciary. He was also fond of practicing law himself and would tell on several occasions as to how he could not find time for active law practice, but fulfilled his wish after his retirement. He practiced law for some years in the Bombay High Court, and he had fond memories of appearances before judges. Though I came in contact with him as a younger son-in-law, I always remained a student. And therefore, when he was working on two books, one of which was already and almost completed, the other book on the constitutional law, I had the proud privilege of assisting him. I could take out some references, and those references were indeed utilized by him. It was very kind of him and generous to have put my name alongside Mrunal Deshmukh's name as persons who assisted him in preparation of this work. It was as a result of his untiring effort, his continuing learning process, that the book entered its second edition in 1992. He was lucky to see that it was published. It is now revised, and the revised edition has been authored by none other than a retired judge of the Supreme Court of India, for whom he had great regard, Her Ladyship, Honorable Mrs. Justice Sujata Manohar. This book, I am telling you friends, received a true recognition and what we call a stamp of approval. When in the case of Jagjit versus State of Haryana, reported in AIR 2007 Supreme Court, page 590, at para 86, Honorable Justice Y.K. Sabharwal, His Lordship, then was the Chief Justice of India, presiding over a 3-judge bench, referred to this book. in the context of the role of a speaker of a legislative assembly. That was a case of expulsion of members from the legislative assembly by the speaker. Whether it was prerogative or whether it is the election commission which should step in, and all the time for performing this duty was the subject of that judgment. And during the course of the judgment, a reference was made to several works, including Dr. T.K. Tope's book. It has also been referred in the context of a president's power to dismiss a elected government in the event there is a constitutional crisis and a breakdown. Friends, there can be lot many memories and lot much can be said, but I must tell you that in setting up a social service league, in reminding all of us of our social obligation and duty, Dr. Tope and Srimati Vinatadevi Tope have remained with us. They would continue to remain with us. They would inspire generations of students coming and entering this college and going out. All that Dr. Tope wanted was that you become good, responsible citizens, socially conscious, and make the most of the opportunities that you get here as a student. Government Law College must get back its name, fame and recognition. That will be a true and real, what would we say, recognition and real service to this social service league and to the memories of Dr. Tope. I am sorry that I will have to leave after some time because the court assembles at 11 o'clock. Before going, I must only tell you that what Dr. Tope did in the form of a social service league is summed up by a poet in four lines. The poet says, "Tum be sahara ho do, kisi ka sahara ho, tumko apne aap hi sahara mil jayega. Kashti koi doobti hui pahuncha lo kinare pe, tumko apne aap hi kinara mil jayega."
Thank you, Your Lordship. Srimati Vinatadevi Tope Social Service League, established in 1966, believes in the concept of different makes a difference. The league strongly believes, don't give a fish to a man, rather teach him how to fish. These thoughts are explicitly expressed through the flagship events like Udaan, Shikhar, Vivechan, Youth for Healthy Mumbai, etc. With this, I welcome amongst us Padma Bhushan Julio Francis Ribeiro, also known as the Super Cop. He is a retired Indian police officer and civil servant. During his legendary career, he has held many positions, which include the Commissioner of Mumbai Police, Director General of Central Reserve Police Force, Director General of Police of Gujarat, Director General of Punjab during Punjab Insurgency, and an Indian Ambassador to Romania. At present, he is the Chairperson of Public Concern for Governance Trust and the staunch supporter of our league. Without further ado, I invite Sir on the stage to share his experiences of collaboration with the league.
Justice Srikrishna, Justice Dharmadhikari, and Saboo, and friends. First of all, let me tell you that I myself was a student of this college from 1948 to 1950, so that is makes it two generations before y'all. And Fali Nariman was my classmate. Of course, I didn't come up to his standard of intelligence at all, but I was not too bad. And I remember Professor Tope, at that time he was not the principal, he was our professor of constitutional law. And he used to teach us dicing. I remember dicey only because of Professor Tope. Otherwise, I've forgotten dicey altogether. And you know that I remember Professor Tope talking to the principal, Chitale, Principal Chitale at that time. And they were wondering how I got so many marks in my final law exam. And they were saying, how has this fellow got this percentage of marks? And then Professor Tope told Principal Chitale, I think it is because he's of his English. His English is good, so that is why he got those marks. Anyway, whatever that the reason could be, I remember my old teachers from this college, Justice Chandrachud and Justice Vimadalal. They used to come to Pune, and when I was the superintendent of police there in 1964, they always walked into my room and said, hello, old student. So it's this with the rapport with the law college is very old and very, very deep. But I've not been too often to the college, except because of, now recently, because of Shivam. Now, how did I come to know Shivam? He applied to our NGO for an internship, and we immediately gave it to him. An internship is only a month, I think, according to university regulations. But even after that, he, like some others also, who were interned with us, they kept touch with us. And they came and attended and actually helped out, particularly in the RTI work which we do in the NGO. Shivam is one of those people whom I feel will be the future leaders of this country. Because they are so involved in their work and they really feel for it. You know, we are all, the trustees are 80 or, I mean, I'm 86, but there are others who are also crossed 80, and there are few who are just coming to that. So they're octogenarians, we call them. And my wife calls us all geriatrics. But we have a number of young people with us, like Shivam, and that makes us extremely eager to do something for society, return to society what society has given us in our days. And whereas they have many good ideas, these young people, we at least try to inculcate our old values, because today the new values disturb us. You know, getting rich quickly at any cost, that I think is a value that we would totally reject. So these new values is what we, old values is what we try to inculcate into young people like Shivam, who intern with us. And I think that some of it has rubbed off. I'm sure with Shivam it is fully rubbed off. But with others, there are people who have taken to it, and I hope that we are able to contribute in this way. So I have attended earlier also one of his functions which was held here, where all these NGOs, many NGOs had sent dance troops of Udan, and they were street children or children from the slums, and it was something that was worth seeing, that this school is, this college is involved and the students are involved in social work. When I came in, I saw many of his colleagues, and they were mostly girls. So I asked him, you got all girls in your committee? And he said, you know, girls are more interested in doing social work, but they'll be happy about me. I'm one of the men who is with. And I think I am happy about it. Lastly, let me tell you that I knew Professor Tope very well, and I also had met his wife, incidentally, because one day he himself organized a get-together of students on the terrace, and he had invited his wife and introduced us to her. And I remember she wore a 9-yard sari. That is one thing that remains in my mind. And Professor Tope was later on when I joined service and I was a deputy commissioner of police in my younger days here in Bombay, I visited him here in the college. He was the principal by that time. And he said, Ribeiro, you must come and do your LLM. You must come and do your LLM. So I said, sir, I'm very busy. I have to go running around and our time is not our own. No, he said, you will find the time. You come. I will be your guide. You please come and you do it. Of course, I didn't do it because I had no intention of studying anymore. That is how I remember Professor Tope. Another thing I remember about him, they said that he was a disciplinarian and that he was also very kind-hearted. Both the things are absolutely correct because I was in the NCC only one year, and he was in charge of the NCC at that time. As a professor, he was given the charge of NCC. And I remember that when we had to hand over all our equipment and clothes, etc., back, he himself took charge of all those. And for some reason, one of I think what was the color, was not khaki, it was something like some other color of shorts that were distributed. I think the dhobi or somebody had made it disappear. So I found that I was short by one. And so I went to the market and bought one and brought it and put it in. He immediately noticed it. He said, no, that is not right. You can't do that. And he said, you'll have to pay for that, for the cost of it, but you take away that. He caught it at once. I thought I would get, it would be brushed over, but it was not. Professor Tope, he didn't say anything more than that. He was very good about it. He said, okay, don't do that such things again. I said, sir, I won't do it again. And I didn't think I would be caught, but I was caught. Be careful when you all do such things. Think of Professor Tope and don't do at least, that is how I look at it. So thank you for calling me Shivam, and I wish your Social Service League another 50 years of good dedicated service to humanity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for those wonderful words.